All right, so as you can see here, I've got that aluminum bar sort of tacked in all the way around the front of the grill shell here. But the problem now is that there's not enough room down here in between the front of the grill shell and the axle anymore. I thought there was enough room there initially. That's why I went ahead with this. But if I took apart the spring shackles there and just let this axle like come all the way up and just like let the frame sit down on the axle moves back a little bit. And it comes like just touching this aluminum. So the grill shell is a little bit too long. What I'm going to do is, since I have this all tacked on here right now, I'm going to use this as a template basically, and I'm going to mark the inside edge of this bar that I just welded on, and then I'll cut these tacks off, take it out, and then just trim the grill shell all the way around that line I just made in there, and that'll shorten it by about half an inch, which should give me enough room. All right, so I've got that grill shell trimmed all the way around the edge. It's a half inch shorter than it was before. As you can see, I also got that aluminum trim tacked back in here, and now there is definitely enough room to clear the front axle there. So now all I have to do is weld this up completely and then sand down the weld to a nice seamless transition. Alright, as you can see now, I've got the grille mounted in here to the grille shell up front, and you can really see the face of the car coming together now with the grille and headlights here. I'm really liking how it's turning out. And this was a lot of work to do this. You saw I made it out of those 1-inch wide strips of stainless steel, and I bent them in half with that big metal brake and then kind of finished up on the vise. Then I went and polished each one, fitted each one to the little frame I made around the inside here, and then welded each one on individually. And the spacing turned out very consistent, actually. Even if you look up close, you really can't see too much inconsistency with it. So I'm happy with that for sure. And those strips were actually like the perfect material to use for the grille here, because they're pretty light, because they're just thin strips, and when you bend them in half, the stainless steel work hardens as well. So they're actually really stiff here. I don't need to put any like horizontal braces in it behind, like you'll see on a lot of grills. They'll have the vertical slats like this, and then a couple like wires behind that weld it up together for that extra strength. But because this is so stiff now after I've bent it, I can move it a little bit like this, but they're definitely not going to bend at all, and they're not certainly not flopping around at all. So that's it for this video. In the next video, I'm going to get back on the drivetrain finally. I know people have been asking about the engine forever. I'm finally getting it back, and I'm going to be doing some crazy things with the drivetrain, so make sure to stay tuned for that, and I'll see you next time.